What's up, guys? Welcome to our YouTube channel and welcome to yet another video once again. Do you want to learn how to open a synthetic trading account and start making cool money? Then you're at the right place, because in this video we'll be going through the processes of opening a binary account. As of now, they are currently rebranding to Derive. I think they are somewhere in the finishing stages of rebranding to Derive. So binary.com and Derive, they're the same thing. And as of now too, they are actually the only brokers I can think about that are offering synthetic trading. Yes, a lot of brokers have synthetic trading, but what makes Derive unique is that you can actually make money when trading synthetic indices. Other brokers trading 212, I know they have synthetic, they have synthetic trading, but it's on demo, so you can't make money out of it. It's just for practice for their new clients and all that. So that's actually the cool thing here. And in case you've been wondering what does synthetic indices mean, we'll all be treating all these stops in this video. So let's get to it after this break. Welcome back, guys. I'm Dima from C2S Enterprises, and in this video we're opening a binary, or like I said, they are rebranding to Derive, a Derive account. And we're going to go through the processes of setting up your account and trading on Derive. There are a lot of things you can do on Derive, and like I said, most especially why people trade with them is because they offer a synthetic trading platform where you can actually make real money. So that's what we're going through today. So please endeavor to subscribe and ring the notification bell so that you don't miss any of our videos. You know, this is a channel where give you value. We are always giving you the what, the when, the why, and the how, the WWWH. Yeah, so we're all about offering you tips as far as trading and investing, digital marketing, and e-commerce are concerned. So please smash that subscribe button and enable the notification bell. And also drop a like for the video if you end up liking the video. Obviously, you're going to like it. And please endeavor to share it with your friends so that everyone can benefit. You know, this all these help the algorithm, and you know, we just gotta do these things for ourselves. So let's get started. I've had a Derive. This is the Derive platform. I've had a Derive account for a while now, so I don't feel like there's any reason for me to open a new one. But for the sake of these tutorials, I'm gonna start afresh with I have some random details which I'm gonna use to open this so that you guys will learn how to open it. So we're going to go through all the steps. So these are the random details we put up. So we'll be opening a Derive account, a binary.com account as the case may be, for this random personnel I generated. Derive, they are currently rebranded from binary.com. This was their former site, binary.com. This was their former site, binary.com. This broker has been around since 2000, so they have been around the market for quite a while now. So they're reputable to an extent. So let's go over to the main site, because we don't want to be using this. We want to go to the main site. I'll leave the link to sign up and the link to what we're doing below. Now, the benefit of using this link is that, you know, most brokers these days, they offer sign up bonuses. So you might get something from them if you use that link, because it's a partner's link. So you might get something. It doesn't hurt, does it? So just use the link and then see what happens. So let's get at it. Let's create a free, you click the link and then it's surely going to take you here where we are right now. So we go to create free demo account. That's actually the first step. Now we have to impute our email. So in this case, we impute the email of, oh, sorry. We generated some, yeah, we impute this email. Your email, as the case may be, this is just you working here. I'm just showing you guys how this whole thing works. So you impute your email and then they'll send you a verification email, as you can see. So we'll go to our mailbox, to this guy's mailbox. You can see the email is here already. So yeah, so verify and start trading. I'm gonna open this in the meantime. So we choose the country we live in. So let's say this the address, the random personal I generated lives in Nigeria. So you input your country as the case may be. So let's go to Nigeria, Nigeria, Nigeria. Okay. Next, we choose a password. So remember, yes, our password is ready. So yes. Now, this is the Reef trading interface. We just logged in. So let me just walk you through all you're seeing here. Like you can see, this is a nice platform, nice user interface, nice user experience. I really love this site, and I think that's part of the reasons why they are rebranding to Reef. So you can use the, you can, let's go through a lot of things you can do here. You can trade on their Ethereum platform, the DTrader. You can use their boats. They have the boats, which we'll be going through this when I'll be teaching you guys how to load it and use this, and obviously use our boats because we have our own boats. Then this is the MT5, which is on MT5, and then this is our smart trader. Now let's go ahead to open these other accounts because that's meant. So now what we have here is we have opened a Deriv Trader account. This account now, a wallet and an account. We have opened this DTrader, but and another thing we want to do is we want to open a real account. We want to open a real account, and then we want to open the MT5 trading account. That's a trading account where we'll trade on MT5. We'll trade synthetic indices, financial markets, and all the rest. Can trade synthetic indices, and then you can also trade financial markets with them, forex, stocks, crypto, and others. They all offer these things. They were actually brokers for these financial reasons before the synthetic part came. So let's go ahead, let's add this account. We'll click add, then we'll choose the fiat, the currency we want our card to be. So you can see, please choose your currency. Usually in this case, we choose US dollars. You can also choose cryptocurrency if you want. You can see if you want a Bitcoin wallet account, if you want Litecoin phone, and all the rest. So click next after clicking USD. Personal details, let's pull up this. Yes, this is Julian Miami Isokon. Let's copy this. This. So in this case, as the case may be, just impute your name. Okay. Date of birth. Let's say this person was born on the. Let's say he or she was born on 1991. Okay, 1991 is good. It's just a January 1st. So let's just put some random figures there. Then the number. I think. I think we have something like this for the number. This is the number it's pulled up. So, what else? That's it. Go over to the next part. There's the address. You put your address. So let's pull up the address for this person. This person lives in 46 Mukumi Street, whatever, whatever. See. It is on the Sekuni Street. You just see this place is in Lagos. And let's say it's in Ikeja. And then Lagos. Lagos State, and then just impute your then postal code. You can see there's no yes, they added a postal code here. Let me see, and then you impute your postal code for. So that's it. You click next, add for address, then terms of use. You read this stuff, terms and condition. You I'm not a political exposed person. I agree to terms and condition. Then you add account. And you let it load, and that's it, guys. You have opened a real US dollar wallet here, so you can go ahead to deposit. But we are gonna click maybe later because I want to show you other things. So now, after creating your wallet, real wallet account, you can see you have a real wallet account, you have a demo wallet account. You can switch between either of them, as the case may be. If you want to practice this demo. And if you want to use your real account, you can switch to real account, which as of now is at zero because we haven't funded the account. So let's go back to next. Let's open a real MT5 account. Now you can trade synthetic indices with these guys. You can also trade financial markets, whether it's trade of financial markets, a financial STP, financial straight to processing account. But for the most part, retail traders, you should be focused on this one. So but we came here to trade synthetic indices, so we'll go ahead to add the synthetic indices. Now you can choose a password for your account. So we're going to put a password for our account. Input your password. Yes, then you add account. Okay, you can see can transfer to the account on the MetaTrader 5, and then you can start trading. Everything is as simple here. Yeah, I like things being simple in my trading. So you can see it. Now this is your login number, which this is the number you log in, and then you need two things when logging into your account. You need the server one. This is DMT5 server. Then this is the login account number, and then the password which you just put now. So if you want to trade on their trading terminal, you right click, open a new tab, and it will take you to the trading terminal. You can see this is the login. Like I said, I said it here. You need the login number. That password you put it. The password you just created. You put it, and then the server. This is the Rift server. If it's demo, you choose demo. If it's the real account, is the Rift server. This is the main two main servers they have. So you click OK. And that's it, guys. You're in here. You can see this is our account. We don't have anything yet. This is 0.0. This is our trading account. Now, a trading account on MT5 is different from your wallet account. Take note of this, guys, if you're new to trading. This is where you trade. This is where you trade. So if you have money here, this balance is different from this balance. Different from this balance. Look at my mouse. If you have money here, if you have money on your Drive wallet, and you want to trade on MT5, you have to transfer money from this Derive MT5 wallet, from this Derive wallet to the MT5 trading platform, because this is where you trade from. And if you want to, maybe you're in profits and you want to withdraw, you move your money here, down here. So we'll talk about all these things now. So let's go over to how we deposit and do all these transfers and withdrawals, and which is where we are going to go. So we go to reports. No, we'll go to cashier, sorry. Now you can see deposit, withdrawal, payment agents, transfer, DP2P. They have a peer-to-peer system of payment. Now can see there are various deposit methods. They have credit and debit cards. They have Pepper Money. They have Skrinet Teller, Web Money, Jeton Wallet, ATM, and Fastapay. Now, they also have payment agents too. Can use payment agents. These are the payment agents. They have a lot of them. They made it in such a way that you have a lot of options. I believe that anyone listed here is credible. So the but my problem here is finding someone with a good rate, because these guys, they are third party and they have their own rates. So you be the one to do the homework. Like, let me say, a crypto FS exchange, you want to deal with these guys, you can see their contacts and their site, and their email where you can contact them. So you do this, you do your homework, do your due diligence, and find someone with a nice rate for you. Now, you can see withdrawal. We don't have any funds for now. That's why we can't withdraw anything. We can't take what you don't have. So, but for the most part, the same method of deposits are the same as withdrawal. So if you have funds to withdraw, the same methods for your deposits was going to be showing there. So let's go through the methods of deposit. So let's go over the deposit. But we have credit cards and all this stuff. Now, I will if you're if I'm left to give you an advice, I don't think my closest option here will be Skrill, because I have a Skrill account. This is my money broker, my money broker wallet. I use them sometimes. Please, if you're in a country where ATM withdrawals take time, let me say somewhere in Africa, please don't use ATM cards. I keep telling you, the energy for giving is not the energy for receiving. Now, these deposits are fast doing with ATM cards, but withdrawals are very, very slow. They are very, very slow, and it's basically not the broker's fault, because this money, it has to do with a lot of people: Visa, Interswitch, your bank, and your bro. So it takes a lot of time. We're talking about 2 weeks minimum. So don't use this, please. If you're going to use this, then you should have an account with these guys. Aside from that, other countries, I'm speaking for my people in Nigeria. So now, if I'm going to give you an advice which you're going to listen to, I advise you to do this, because this is how I do with my own too. I add another account. I add a Bitcoin account, a crypto account, as the case may be. But in this case, it's usually Bitcoin. If you have Ethereum or whatever, is that if that's your choice, fine. Now, you see why we do this. Now, I've created a Bitcoin account now. I can deposit to this account. Now, here's the thing. Now, I deposit with the, Bitcoin is just decentralized. Nobody tells you when to send your coin. Nobody does. As in, you're just your boss of your own with cryptocurrency. So you deposit. You can see if you want to deposit, you can see the Bitcoin deposits just showed up. So you deposit into your wallet. This is your wallet address. You deposit here, and then the coins will reflect here, and then you transfer these coins to your USD account. It's as simple as that. Same for withdrawal. If you want to withdraw, look at what my mouse is. Look at the screen, please. If you want to withdraw, you withdraw from your USD account to your Bitcoin wallet, as in to your Bitcoin wallet here too, and then you take your money. It's as simple as that. Now, how do you do these transfers in and out of this place? Is here. We don't have any money here, so this, yeah, you can see it's not showing. So, but that's whether you want to transfer from your Bitcoin wallet to your real wallet, or you want to transfer from your real wallet to your MT5 wallet, this is where you do it. In case of the future, this is where you do this stuff. It's a simple step. You click here, it is going to show you whether you want to transfer from your wallet to this guy, or you want to transfer from your wallet to your Bitcoin, from your fiat wallet to your Bitcoin wallet. It's going to show you this. It's a simple step, so it doesn't matter if I'm not showing it. As you can see, there's no money here. That's what it will show. So this is your other account. Now let's just take for instance, you deposit now. You want to deposit. This is what you're gonna do. You're gonna go to your Bitcoin wallet. This is my advice though. If you're going to take it, you go to your Bitcoin wallet. Can see deposit. You deposit, you send your coins to this address on your wallet address, whatever your wallet will be. You send the amount you want to deposit into your wallet to this decision. Now, when it reflects, Bitcoin transfer usually take couple hours to confirm. At least it's better than waiting for 2 weeks for your money. So when you withdraw now, and when you deposit, sorry.
Now you go the amounts must have reflected here. You go to your this thing, you go to transfer, sorry. If you go to transfer, there's going to be some set of instructions showing you how to transfer from this Bitcoin wallet to this USD wallet. So it's going to show up up here. So it's not something hard. So after that, when you do that here, if you go to your wallet, you see your money has reflected. And now from here too, you go to transfer, this same transfer. If you want to trade on MT5, there's also instructions here showing you how to transfer from this wallet on Deriv to your MT5 wallet so that you can trade. If you do that, the money will reflect here and then you can trade. Now, if you have made profit and you want to withdraw, you click and you go back here on transfer. You see, this in to transfer from MT5 here to your fiat money wallet, that's your USD wallet here. It's as simple as that. Then when that money reflects, there's also an option to transfer from here, from your wallet to your Bitcoin wallet. If you do that, the money is going to reflect on your Bitcoin wallet. It's going to reflect on your Bitcoin wallet. Then you go to your Bitcoin wallet, click withdrawal, and withdraw your money. It's as simple as that. In a couple of hours, your bitcoins will show, and then you do whatever you want to do with it. It's as simple as that. All this thing happen in hours. But if you're using ATM withdrawals, of course, deposit will be fast, but withdrawals will take a lot of time. And likewise, other methods too. The only method I would recommend, size this one, is the web, is the money broker. That's when you're using Skrill or this thing. Another cool option is payment agents. But payment agents, Nigerians know how most of these companies behave. I don't know about them. I don't know about them, but you really need to do your homework here and do this thing. But instead of going through the stress, all those stress, find this thing. If you have your Bitcoin, we usually help people. We are crypto merchants. We buy and sell Bitcoin, so we can help you convert your Bitcoin to cash. Understand? So Bitcoin won't be a problem here. Whether you're using Bitcoin or Ethereum or any cryptocurrency, we can help you change that to your money. Understand? So that's it, guys. Guys, a lot of people might be asking, does this broker ask for verification documents? Well, all I can say is not comp. I really like these guys' documents. You can do that. You can go live chat. You can go live chat, and then you can chat them up. You can send your documents. You can chat them up and send your documents. It's not hard. They even made it simple. You chat them up, and then you send those stuff if you want. But it's not compulsory so far. So that's it. You just put your stuff and then you can start trading. It's as simple as that. So we'll have a course on how to trade on this platform. You know, this is a different platform. These markets, they have how as in they behave in certain ways. Every market has a way it behaves. So the way you trade here is not the way you trade, especially synthetic indices, the volatility 100 index, volatility 75, all these stuffs. The way you trade them is a bit listen because these markets, these synthetic indices, they are going to behave slightly different from the normal forex, you know. So we'll have a course on this coming out. The link is going to be in the description below when the course is ready. So just be checking out the description box. And if at the time you're watching this and it's ready, then you're in luck. Either ways, the link is going to be in the description. We're going to update that when it's out. So guys, it's going to be everything you need to start trading. Believe us, we don't do nonsense. If you follow us by now, you already know this. So when we say we are doing something, we are really doing it, and we're really doing it good because we believe that anything worth doing is worth doing well. So guys, remember to smash that subscribe button, destroy that subscribe button, enable the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any video. And then you like and share these videos. I know you like them, so there's no point asking if you like it. This is real value. So share it to your friends so that I get value to you. These stuffs, they help the YouTube algorithm and they help these videos get recommended to people and let people have and get value from this. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Thanks. If you also have questions, leave it in the comment section. So that's it.